I play drums and listen to prog metal 93.6% of the time. There are a ton of excellent drummers at work here, like these, but I want to talk about some drummers who, from my experience, don't quite get their due, at least not on the Reddits and YouTubes and prog sites that I frequent. Norway's Circus Maximus came onto the scene as a cover band in 2000, playing some hardcore prog metal from bands like Dream Theater and Symphony X. They dropped their first album, The First Chapter, in 2004 and came out of the gate swinging. This dude Trolls is solid as a rock. He's quick, steady, and his drums always sound great. Crisp cutting. I really like to play this part because the hi-hat is going at a steady quarter note. Feet are going on 16th notes. And then you got the snare mimicking the rhythm of the rest of the band. Really fun part to play. Also from Norway, Pagan's Mind started in 2000. They have a very similar sound to Circus Maximus, which is not an insult. Stian's drum parts are always really fun to play. His drumming is always very clean, and his drums also sound great. His forte is not really creativity, but he is very solid. He loves Berlikas. He loves those Berlikas. This is Atomic Firelight. Lots of fun parts to play here. He's not really known for his speed, but there's this song here, Painted Skies, which is okay, and not that fast a song, but at the end, out of nowhere, he decides to really show his feet. Like what? I like it when you know a drummer is fast, but doesn't have to show it off all the time. Beyond Twilight popped into the scene like 2001 with their symphonic dark prog, made three amazing albums, changed their name to Zeolar, and made one more, then faded into oblivion. This album is a true masterpiece, with some really great footwork. Just give it a listen. This is my favorite part of the whole album. He comes up with some really cool parts on most of his stuff. I recommend everything this band has ever done. Jason Rulo has to put up with a lot of these random hits type riffs from Mike Romeo. Like, a lot. And he handles it with aplomb. Jason's solid and tight drummer with pretty quick feet. Plus, once I saw them live, and it was the first time I ever saw a drummer do that thing where they swing their heels back and forth when doing 16th notes, I laughed. But now I do it sometimes. Some pretty cool fills in this song. Sometimes he comes up with a pretty sweet groove like this one. Usually has some pretty creative ride cymbal work too. He's got a pretty aggressive and tight part going on this song. This is Set the World on Fire. He's pretty good at odd time signatures and not making them sound too stock. This is Inferno. Speaking of tight, I'd say Adagio, as a whole, doesn't get as much recognition as they should. They've had four or five excellent albums. This is Vampiri from Archangels in Black. They fall into the same sort of category and sound as Symphony X, but in my opinion, their quality has stayed high, whereas Symphony X and I haven't seen eye to eye as the years have gone by. But I digress. This dude Eric is super tight and fast. I like how he kind of switches the functions of the hi-hat and snare here. You got the snare doing eighth notes and the hi-hat doing quarters. You just never really hear that, at least I don't. Adagio got a new drummer for their latest album. Apparently his name is Jelly. They adopted a genty sound for some of the songs and did it really well. But I like genty sounds. If you don't, then just focus on how tight he's rocking this genty riff and ignore his bad hair. I was obsessed with these guys when this album came out. Fortress. Their sound sort of lost some of its savor with me on their next two albums, but Fortress made a big impression on me. It was extreme and in your face and really proggy and really tight. Really powerful drum inclusions with the riffs, of which there are many. All three of these songs are on Fortress. Here's a nice little drum fill. I never really hear anyone talk about Suspire, but I love them. They had, I think, four albums? All of them are good, but A Great Divide was my favorite collection of jams. Sam Policelli played drums in their early days. You may know him as Simis66. Got a very active YouTube page. Also did some recent stuff with Devin Townsend. He played with Decrepit Birth, Code Horror, Abigail Williams, Mutiny Within, Dark Empire. This guy's a heck of a metal drummer. He's very fast. His hands and feet are in the 1%. He can do some blast beats all day long, and he knows his stuff. He deals with odd times very well and does some great hi-hat and cymbal work here. I never hear anyone ever talking about Andromeda, but they were and are fantastic. They haven't put out an album in years, but they haven't broken up either. They were one of the first prog bands I discovered since I got into the genre in the early 2000s. Their musicality is in the top 1%. Vocals, I could take them or leave them, and their lyrics are truly abysmal. They sing about American politics, and they're Swedish, and their name's Andromeda. Anyway, Thomas is a fantastic drummer. He's fast when he needs to be, but what I like most about him is his parts are very creative. Lots of great cymbal and hi-hat work. I'm only going to show this one song, One in My Head, from the album Two is One. The band does this really cool gradual slowdown, but Thomas keeps the snare, and only the snare, going at the original tempo the whole time. I love stuff like that. Let's watch it happen. And the hi-hat, I can see his hi-hat leg going too. Oh, so good. This is my most recent find on the list. This is one of the craziest bands out there with the most diverse sounds of any band in recent memory. And Sylvain is a crazy drummer. I definitely thought the drums on this album were programmed when I first heard it. And it wasn't until I saw this documentary, which is on YouTube and is riveting to watch, that I was proven otherwise. This guy sounds like a computer. And I mean that as a compliment. He hits the drums as hard as balls with the butt end of those big tree trunk sticks and does it really fast. And his feet are super fast too. Leo Margaret. He's French, he lives in Sweden, and he's a drummer for my favorite band of all time. And part of the reason they are my favorite is their drum parts. They're the most creative and interesting parts I know of, and my favorite to play. I have corresponded with Leo online a little bit, and he said that Daniel Gildenlow, the Pain of Salvation driving force, writes many of the drum parts and bases many of the song's riffs after them. So no, Leo doesn't write many of the parts, but he has to learn them and play them perfectly. And if what I've heard about Daniel is true, if Leo doesn't play them perfectly, Leo is fed to the dogs. His parts have so many polyrhythms that who can even tell what some of the time signatures are. Like here, the kick hits 5, then 5, then 4, then 3, then 2, then 1, and it repeats. I cannot play this song. He's doing the same thing now, but the snare is going double time. I'm not gonna sit here and show off all the cool parts that Leo plays. Here's a list of some of the cool songs to check out. I'm not gonna show them all, but all these have really cool parts. Well, that's it. That's a list of the most underrated prog drummers of all time, in my opinion.